Well, howdy, howdy, howdy. I am glad to be here. Hope you are too. I want to talk about which hot dog brand. Now, I've done many videos on this, but I'm going to sum this up for you, okay? Because there, you probably have a favorite brand. I have a favorite brand, or I have about two or three favorite brands. But there's so many good hot dogs out there, so which one do you choose? Do you go with Sabrette? Do you go with Nathan's, one of these huge national brands? Or do you go with something that is hometown? Maybe you've got a, like I have a Swaggerty's, that makes all kinds, and I've got Lay's, a company called Lay's. It's got little three little pigs on the package. They make hot dogs near me. And so, well, who do you go with? And so I'm going to give you your first indicator. Go to a couple grocery stores, go to the hot dog aisle, and see what they carry the most of. That's one indicator, because they keep good statistics on what gets sold, and so they stock up more and display more of the more popular ones. So that's one heads up. And you may go, but Ben, that's Oscar Mayer. Well, some people love Oscar Mayer. And if your area loves Oscar Mayer, then serve freaking Oscar Mayer and then have you a specialty quarter pound dog beside it. Okay? Now, everybody pretty much everywhere has heard of Nathan's. Nathan's is a great, great hot dog. And will work about anywhere. Sabrette's works in some places, Florida and some New England states. It's not everywhere, okay? Vienna, another fantastic brand, delicious as heck. But you come to the South and you say Vienna, and a lot of people, unless they're from the North, they go, what? And they think of those little sausage cans of Vienna sausages. And they think mush, right? It's great for a camping trip when you're super hungry. But it ain't so great to think about as your lunch on a hot dog that's bigger mush. So those are the things you have to look at, and you don't want to have to train your customer base. I got into Vienna, and it was a mistake for me. Not that Vienna was bad. It was just I was having to train people. Everybody, I'd have to go, no, it ain't like the sausage can stuff. No, totally different company, blah, blah. And why go through all that? Why not serve what people want? So the biggest advice I can give you, look at your grocery store. Number two, go and have a taste test with your friends, family, neighbors, whoever. Do a gathering. It's a great time to practice on your cart and serve, but you can do a taste test, okay? How do you pull off a taste test? You cut dogs up, and you put colored toothpicks in certain brands, and you keep a little sheet of what it is, and then you ask them, which brand did you like better? Did you like the red toothpick brand or the blue toothpick? You know what I'm saying? And then that way you kind of get a feel for what your area is going to eat. So, I would never encourage you to just pick some random brand that maybe like Vienna or Sabrette's when your area doesn't know what that is. There's no reason to do that. And there's also never a reason to me to be marketing their brand. I want it to be Ben's, you know, Hillbilly Hot Dogs. So, when Mike won the world record, he's one of our vendors, had two of my carts, and he got the world record for the most expensive hot dog. He, if you asked him what brand, he goes, oh, it's Mike's Hot Dogs brand. That's what it is. Mike's carts. That's my brand. And so he never told anybody because he always seasoned his water a certain way, and he made sure that it was his brand. He could have been buying Nathan's. He could have been buying Baker's and Chef's from Sam's Club, whatever he was buying. I used Baker's and Chef's from Sam's Club for the entire time, except for the Vienna. So it's very easy to make that happen and be your own brand, because you want to brand you, not, you don't want to be marketing for someone else. Unless it's so popular in your area that it's going to be a value, then if I'm in Champaign, Illinois, I'm going to have signs that say Vienna served here. Okay? I get it. But if I'm in Podunk, Georgia, or Podunk, East Tennessee, it's going to be my brand. It's going to be a Ben's hot dog. It's not something else. So that's what I would tell you to do. But do the taste test and get a feel for it. Don't give them all the toppings for the taste test, because that can drown out the flavors. Some people will ask me, inevitably, Ben, what about casings versus natural casings to no casings? Which one should I choose? Well, you choose... You choose the one that your area likes. Because if your area is used to natural casings and the snap of that, then you do that. One of my favorite brands is Zweigel's. Okay? It's up north. Okay? And it's delicious. and you can have them shipped in and try them. They've got one called the Red and White Pop Opens. Every time you cook them, no matter how you cook them, they pop open in places. They are freaking delicious. I'm talking delicious. But nobody knows them here. I can't get them readily available here. You know, it cost a bunch of money just to ship a case to me when I'm doing friends and family. So I didn't put those on the cart. But there's some awesome brands like that. So look for your local brands first if that's popular in your grocery stores. Then that's what you serve, right? So I hope that helps you. I'll be back with more tips and tricks every single day. I love you. Bye.